Hey fellow animators, I'm Miloš Černý. So, you already know this model. We have done analysis and rig for it already in previous videos. You can also download this whole finished model on my website for free, if you want to try these tutorials for yourself or animate something cool. But now, let's continue with skinning. This whole process will be quite long, so it will be separated into more videos. Okay, so hide all the props we will not need at the moment and let's get to it. Head to Modify panel and apply a skin modifier. I had one already applied from the videos before, but deleted it and reapplied the new one, just to be sure everything is in its default state. Now add all the main body part bones and create a motion layer to test out if everything works alright. Now to the most boring part of the whole skinning process, at least for me, creating the test animation where we have to animate all the bones we are going to skin, just to see how they deform as we are skinning them. For this video, I decided not to cut this part off completely so you can see how I do this. However, it's nothing too special or exciting. But first, I am doing a quick pose, not an animation yet. A pose where he is trying to touch the ground with his head. I found out that for animal models, this pose can be often challenging, because of the way the models are created. Same with this one, as I talked about in the analysis video also. Neck might have a problem to reach the ground, while still looking okay. So that's why I'm trying it now. This is with the default skin, however, so I'm just looking for the bone positions and rotations that look kind of okay and are not deforming the mesh too much, so that I know what will the problematic parts be when I will be skinning them. Maybe even check if I need to reposition some pivots of the bones to make it look better. But in the end, I have decided that the pose can work as it is and to keep everything like this for now. Okay, so now to the other layer with the actual animation of all the bones. I will not cut this off, but I will speed it up at least. It's hard to say what you guys really want to see and what can be cut off to speed the tutorials up and to respect your time. However, I know that I always hated when I was learning stuff and watching tutorials myself, when I was following tutorials step by step, but then the cut happened and suddenly I was lost. I didn't know what happened in between, and if something wasn't exactly in my file as it was in the tutorial one, I immediately blamed that something during the cutoff part must have happened, and because of that it is not the same in my file, even if it wasn't the case. So I try to do these videos with as few cuts as possible, but I still want to respect your time as well and don't want them to be 1 hour long each time. That's why I speed up the less important part. Don't forget that you can always slow down the video on YouTube if you need to. So I am still setting up the animation for the bones, but try to use this process for also checking out how the individual parts of the mesh deform with the default skin, and think about what parts will be harder so you know what to focus on. Don't do things mindlessly, always try to look at the result and think about what might need improvements during any part of the whole rigging process. Okay, well, the animation is finally finished, and this is how it looks like. I usually always find out later on that I forgot to animate some particular move, but you can always add that later if needed. This is enough to start from. Now let's do some skin fixing. Give it a blank texture so we can see the mesh better. I usually start with setting up envelopes first. They cannot fix everything, but they are a nice base to start from. Let's begin with a simpler things first, like tail for example. The tail can be actually probably done just with the envelopes. It doesn't have any other part of the model nearby, so we can expand those envelopes quite far, which we need to because we want a nice long blend between the bones. Overall shape of the tail, when we move all the bones together, looked okay already, but when you look at the animation of individual bones, it still needs some adjustments. When we expand the envelopes even more, it looks much nicer. Okay, tail done, let's move to the legs. I don't have any specific tips for the envelope process. You just want to move through every bone and try to move, expand or collapse the envelopes to get as close to the final result as possible. It will never be perfect, but sometimes you can get pretty close. Like with the knee here, for example. Or the tail. Fingers are usually so close to each other that they affect each other. But it doesn't matter. Just look at the deformations around the joints and try to make them look okay. However, in the end I decided that the fingers aren't even worth it, because they have only few edge loops to set and it will not be hard to skin them manually. Move through rest of the bones in a similar fashion. Places like pelvis, spine and chest are hard to do with just envelopes, because there is a lot of overlaps. However, go through them as well, you might need to make them smaller, but even default blend can sometimes work alright in fact. Envelopes are best for separated parts like legs, tail or neck for example. Okay, let's keep it at this for now. Even though the envelopes are quite clunky and not very user-friendly to work with, don't overlook them, because they can give you a very nice base to start from and save you a lot of work during the manual skinning. I will do the rest of the skinning process in a future videos. Let me know what else would you like to see, because the views on the channel are kind of stagnating recently, so I would be interested to know what you might enjoy. Of course, thanks to all my Patreons and see you in the next video. I am Miloš Černý and thank you for watching.